Hello and welcome to the session on the strength of material. So in this session we'll be learning the basics of slope and deflections of beams. So I am Professor V.V. Khond, Mechanical Engineering Department at KKR Institute of Engineering Education and Research, Nasi. So we start the session. So first we will see what are the beams. So beams are the horizontal structural member used to support horizontal loads such as floors, then roofs, then decks. So the picture shown over is of different beams. So these are the horizontal structural member and they will be used to support the loads. So we'll go with the main topic, that is the slope and deflections of beams. So the picture shown over is a simply supported beam with a point or concentrated load at the center. So there are some deflections, there is some elastic curve. So first we'll see the basics, that is the deflection. What is deflection? Deflection at any point is the vertical distance between the axis of beam before and after loading at that point. It is denoted by Y or it is denoted by delta. So this is the distance Y. Okay, this is the distance Y from this point to this point, so that is distance Y. So these are all always zero at the supports. So now we will go with the slope. Slope at any point is defined as angle in radian between the tangent to the elastic curve at that point and the original axis of the beam. So let us say this is the point, we are drawing the tangent, this is the elastic curve. So the maximum deflection is this one, that is Y. Here the deflection is 0 at point A, at point B, that is the deflection is 0. So if you take any point on the elastic curve, if you take this particular point, then draw the tangent over here, then whatever the angle between the tangent and the horizontal line, so that is being the slope and it is measured in radian. Okay. So this is what we can say, it is slope and it denoted by theta. Then it is denoted by dy by dx or it is denoted by theta. It is deflection is denoted by delta. So now we come to the boundary condition. So for the boundary conditions, let us say simply supported. So there may be two cases. So first case is the simply supported beam. So this is the case of simply supported beam. So for the these are what the standard boundary conditions we can say. So at support the deflection is always zero because the Y is equal to zero over here. So the deflection is always zero at the support. That is the standard condition. Again, at support the slope is always maximum. So if you take the angle over here, so it is always maximum. Then the next condition is maximum deflections occur at a point where the slope is zero or vice versa. So let us say at this point maximum deflection occurs at point where the slope is zero. If you draw the tangent over here, that will become parallel. So this parallel line and this line, so that will be angle will be equal to zero. So the slope will be equal to zero. So that is what we can say, it's maximum deflections occur at point where the slope is equal to zero. Then boundary conditions for the cantilever. So let us say this is the cantilever. You can observe here, so theta is equal to zero, Y is equal to zero at fixed end, and at the free end, so the deflection is maximum, that is Y maximum, and theta maximum, that is slope is maximum. So these are the boundary conditions. So for the cantilever beam, we can say at fixed support deflection is always zero. Then at fixed support the slope is always zero. Then at free end the deflection is maximum. Then at free end the slope is maximum. Then we can go over the relations between the deflection, slope and the bending moment. So let us say this is the beam, AB is the beam, this is the deflection, this is the curve. We can say A to B is the elastic curve, ADB, this is elastic curve. We are projecting the elastic curve to draw the circle. So this becomes the radius of curvature of the elastic curve. R becomes the radius of curvature of the elastic curve. So this line is tangent to the circle at point A. So which will give you maximum slope theta A. Over here, this theta A and this theta A, this becomes the same by using the law of geometry. Okay, so let us say the L be the span of beam, M be the bending moment, R is the distance of curvature of beam after bending, then Y is the deflection of beam at center, then theta is the slope of beam. So we go with the, so from the figure you can see AC multiplied by BC is equal to CE multiplied by CD. So AC over here, AC into BC is equal to CE into CD. So that is the relation for the chord of a circle. So by using the chord of circle equation, we can write down the similar. So AC value is L by 2, CB value is L by 2, then the equation will go like this. So CE, that becomes twice R, that is the diameter of circle, minus Y, that becomes CE multiplied by CD, so that is equal to Y. So by, if you go, if you expand the equations, you can get L square by 4 is equal to twice RY minus Y square. So in practice, deflection of beam Y is very small and the square of Y is negligible. So we can eliminate that thing. So L square by 4 is equal to twice R Y we get. Then Y is equal to L square by 8 R. L is the length of beam, R is the radius of curvature, and Y is the deflection. So we can get the relation between Y and radius of curvature. So, but by using the bending formula, we can get M by I is equal to E by R by using the bending formula. So R will be equal to E into I by M. Then you have to put the value of R in equation 1, that is previous equation, Y is equal to, then we get Y is equal to ML square upon 8 EI. So this is the equation between Y, that is the deflection, and M, that is the bending moment. So Y is equal to ML square upon 8 EI. I is the moment of inertia. Okay. So from the geometry of figure, we can get sin theta A is equal to AC upon AO is equal to L by 2 upon R is equal to L upon twice into EI upon M. So from the geometry can easily get down the equation AC upon AO. So AC value is L by 2, AO value will be equal to R by R. So since theta A is very small, so sin theta A is equal to theta A. We can get theta A is equal to, we can easily get that thing, ML upon twice EI. So this is the relation between slope and the bending moment. So here we can get, here we can get Y and M, here we can get slope and M. So it is in measured in radian. So again, the important thing here is the product of E into I. So that will be the flexural rigidity, that is measured in Newton meter square. So product of E into I, that is the flexural rigidity. So when we go with the differential equations of the deflection curve, let us take a cantilever. Okay. Let us take a cantilever over here. So cantilever will get deflected. Okay. So we can have the radius of curvature here for the cantilever. In the previous case, we have taken the simply supported beam and the radius of curvature. But in the case of cantilever with one end fixed, so in that case the radius of curvature can be get down from such kind of thing. So R into del theta is equal to ds. So this is ds is equal to dx. So the distance is very small. We can easily take down with respect to dx. So that is what the thing. Then 1 by R is equal to d theta by dx. Okay, proper framing it. Then del theta is equal to del y by del x. So del theta is the slope, and slope for the slope, we can easily get down the slope of a curve, that is equal to del y upon del x. Okay, so replacing del theta by del y by del x, so we can get 1 by R is equal to d square y upon dx square. So from the engineering beam theory, we can get M by I is equal to E by R, that is equal to 1 by R is equal to M upon E I Z. Okay, E I Z, that is I in Z direction. So which is, can easily replace d square y by dx square. So this will become now the main important equation for the slope and deflection, that is the curvature equation. So 1 by r is equal to m by ei is equal to d square y by dx square. Then these are the reflection the curve and these are the differential equations. So curvature is a basic equation. Curvature is the basic equation. So this is our equation. So this becomes the flexural stiffness, this becomes the curvature, and this becomes the bending moment. So we can write down flexural stiffness, or we can write down over here flexural rigidity. So if you integrate the equations like this, so we can get the equation for the slope, that is the governing equation for the slope, like this. Okay, so then again if you integrate this equation, so that becomes the double integration. So EIY is equal to a double integration of M. So first integration and second integration. So that will become the governing equation for the deflection. So these are the two equations. So if you know the equation for the curvature, or if you know the equation for the bending moment, so by double integrating it, we can get the deflection. So where C1 and C2 are you can easily find out from the boundary condition. So curvature, then slope and the deflection. So curvature is r, slope divided by dx, and the deflection. Okay. Then the basic equations for the elastic curve. So this is what the equations for the elastic curve. Ei d to the power 4y upon dx to the power 4 is equal to minus w, that is equal to rate of loading. Then another is, so if you integrate the rate of loading equation, we can get the equation for the shear force. So EI dqy upon dxq is equal to S, that is shear force. Again, if you integrate this equation, you can get the equation for the bending moment, that is EI d square y upon dx square is equal to M. That will become the governing equation for the bending moment. Then if you integrate the equation for the bending moment, you can get the equation for the slope. EI dy by dx is equal to theta. That becomes the slope. Again, if you integrate this equation, you can get the equation for the deflection. Okay. So for the shear force and the bending moment, so we have used these relations, and in the slope and deflection again we have used this equation. So this becomes the basic of the equation for the engineering beam theory. That is the equation for the bending moment, EI d square y upon dx square. So if you go upward, you have to differentiate it. If you go downwards, you have to integrate it. So these are what we can say, these are the equations for the elastic curves. So these are the references. Okay. So thank you for listening. If you really like this video, then like it. Also please subscribe my YouTube channel by pressing the bell icon button and never miss the updates. So thank you for listening.